cooking with Kyle today, and he has busy families in mind. Take a look. We're going to toss together this delicious chopped pork. And the best part is a crock pot will do all the work for you. Kyle, this is an inexpensive meal. And I have to tell you, when we first got married, this was my best friend.
You know the crock pot.
Well, that's right.
Let me tell you what I like about this. It really is delicious. It's easy. It's very lean.
Okay.
And it takes a good 8 hours. Plug it in, walk out the door, go to work. It's cooking on low, so it's never going to get that hot.
Right.
Come home, wham, bam, it's done.
And you have great leftovers, too.
Oh, you have plenty. Perfect. Okay, well, we're actually ready to pull ours out.
What we have done is we have taken
a pork loin.
Okay.
Not a tenderloin, but just the regular loin, which is a little bit bigger. You'll see that in a second. And what we have did with it is we took some crushed tomatoes to put in the bottom of our crock pot.
Okay.
Not a ton. Poured some over it after we coated it with just salt, pepper, I like a decent amount of garlic powder, and some chili powder or, you know, some chili seasoning.
Boy, it smells good.
It does smell good. And this, from here, we can kind of do what we want, but I'm thinking more in terms of football weekends and kids home from school and also the night of Halloween. Nothing better than a little chopped barbecue pork.
That's a great idea.
So for the great reveal, we go. Now, this has been off, so it's just barely on, and I've let it cool down.
All right.
So don't, you know, you would not want to do this if you had not cooled it a bit. Okay, so now watch this. Now this is, again, you can see the pork loin. It's the whole loin.
Yeah.
I always do leave some fat on the bottom,
okay,
but you'll have what's called a fat cap on this thing. Take some off.
Okay.
Okay.
Before you start cutting
before
on it, you
start,
mean?
Before you start even cooking
oh,
it.
I see.
And
okay,
then if you want to remove the fat, it's going to pull right off. A little bit of it adds flavor, but just watch how this thing just falls apart.
Mm-hmm.
Now, bottom line, this cut of meat is fairly inexpensive. But I kid you not.
Ooh, look at that.
Look
that
how
looks beautiful.
Beautiful that is. And you can see I am just barely touching it. And the knife is just cruising right on through it. So it's extremely tender. It is still moist. And all we have to do to it, to have what we have in the picture, is literally chop it up.
Oh, that doesn't take much at all.
Now,
yeah, that's great.
If you decide that you want to have slices, let it cool. That's the big thing, because again,
if you do it when it's hot, it's going to fall apart.
Well, just even now, it's just peeling apart.
Oh,
and
it's
this
so tender.
This is not a hot piece of meat at this point. Okay, so anyway, chopping, again, it's a personal consistency thing, but just crisscross it back and forth, kind of a knife skill type deal. And you know, you can make this chunky or you can make it really just down to absolutely nothing. Now, from there, I'm going to show you another trick I like. I'm kind of a purist, so when I do this, I leave it a little bit chunkier than what I did in the picture, and it's a little bit more traditional. But now what I'm going to do is take a little bit of our pan drippings or juices and use those just to kind of moisten it.
So it's just like a chopped pork. There you
go. It's exactly what it is. It's one of those things you could go to your favorite barbecue place or even into a grocery store and buy a container of chopped pork, and we know what we pay for that. Well, you
this
can make your
cheaper.
Own at home. Well, and it's a lot better.
Yeah.
And then the other thing is, and then really for, you've got to figure this is one half of a pork loin.
And then what do you do with the other sauce?
All this is barbecue sauce.
Oh,
it can be
nice.
Served on the side, or we can drizzle it over.
Oh, that makes
sense. Toss
that
it all
so good,
in,
it?
And you have really enough from a 4 to 6 pound roast, close to 16 sandwiches.
And you can freeze it. Don't forget. Now, you
Absolutely.
Can find the recipe on our website, KFOR.com.